love is not. So they that fear God, love not the abominations. So if you fear God, if you follow God, if you love God, you got to look at what he says in abomination, and you got to stay way away from it.
Christ! Christ! Who's the king?
Christ!
Who's the king?
Christ!
Why don't I
stay? We calling out, we crying aloud on the highways and hedges, repent or die. We give
Benjamin, Benjamin, which is the West Indians, Levi, which are the Haitians, and then Judah, that's the American black.
We crying aloud, O Israel, repent or die.
Do you know your father? According to the Bible, no, your physical father, earthly father. Is he a so-called black man? Where's he from?
Jesus is Lord. Oh, Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Oh, so get your mind right.
My fierce anger for all the earth, for all the earth, everywhere you go. I don't care how many so-called white people got these bunkers. All the earth
shall be devoured.
Shall be what?
Devoured.
You ever see the people by the pool? You ever seen that? It ain't a pretty sight, is it? That's what's gonna happen.
My ride. Listening to you when you was telling them that this is the oldest history book. He's absolutely right. I want to show y'all something. When he said that this is our history book, it is. It's the oldest. But when I say man, I'm talking about the black, Spanish, and Native Americans. This is only written to us. You know, this ain't for the Chinese people, the Arabs. Did y'all know that?
Right.
Hold up. You're right. Because God created man. He actually created everybody. But let me show you something. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6.
So it's for everybody.
No, I'm going to show you something. Because a lot of people think that. And we've been taught that our whole lives. That the Bible is for everybody and it's for everyone. I'm going to show you something that a lot of people don't know. Watch this. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. So it says, thou art a holy people to the Lord thy God. So it's talking to a specific group of people. Matter of fact, we're going to go to Deuteronomy 1 and 1. Watch, I'm about to show you. Hold on. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel. So, brother, you heard it say, these are the words he spoke to all Israel, right? So Israel is a specific group of people. Okay, watch this. That's the people on this sign. All these people make up Israel, okay? So that's not everybody, just these people. But watch what it says about these people. Go to Deuteronomy 7 and 6. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. It says thou art an holy people. The word holy, all it means is separate. All it means is a separate people, right? Watch this. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself. So it says the Lord thy God chose thee to be a special people to himself. So it's something about these people on this sign that's special to the Most High.
What about the people that's over here?
I'm going to get that. That's a great question. Now hold on. Watch this. Above all people that are upon the face of the earth. So what did God just say about Israel?
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
So the Most High God said he chose these people to be above. He said all people on the face of the earth. So it's a difference. He made everybody, but he chose a specific group of people. That's like you got a whole bunch of clothes in the closet, you got a whole bunch of shoes, but you got one pair of shoes that you like more than the rest of them, right? That's what the Most High God is saying about us.
God is magnificent.
Exactly.
Can I say?
But why wouldn't he?
No.
See, this is a problem, bro.
Oh,
I know, but listen, this is the problem. I'm telling you, I'm reading out of the Bible how the Most High God said that you are better than the rest of the people on the earth, and you don't want that. You don't want that for yourself. You like, nah.
Just know because that's how I feel. But God is.
So listen, if you got a child, right? If you got a child and you dropping her off in school, tell her, baby, you the smartest child in all the classes. She say, no, daddy, we all the same.
About the high, most high.
Read. Watch this, bro. The book of 2nd Esdras, chapter 5, verse 24. And of all lands of the whole world, thou have chosen thee one pit, and of all the flowers, thereof one lily. So, brother, I'm going to let you speak as soon as I finish the scripture. All of this, this Bible is saying all the Most High's favorite things. Watch this. This is all the Bible is saying right here, y'all. Listen. And of all the depths of the sea, thou hast filled thee one river, and of all building cities, thou hast hallowed Zion unto thyself, and of all the fowls that are created through his name, be one dove. So he said he got his favorite river, he got his favorite flower, he got his favorite mountain. Go ahead. And of all the cattle that are made, thou hast provided thee one sheep. He got his favorite animal. And among all the multitudes of the people, thou hast gotten thee one people. And he has his favorite people. That's all I'm trying to tell you, that the Most High God has favorites, and we are his favorite people, the people on his side. That's all I'm trying to tell y'all. And we reading out the Bible. Now, come on, bro, what you got? Hold on, bro, he's next. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Why you got black? Or why you got white man? So let me ask you this. No, and you're absolutely right. Because when we come out here, but see, listen. I let you talk to you. Now, when I talk, you wave your arms and walk over.
He can explain all that.
So listen, I'm not. You're absolutely right. When we come down here, we do come out here to win souls for Christ, right? Hold on. And when you have a debate, that means two people going back and forth, right? Right? So listen, if I read something that you don't agree with, you gonna have something to say, right? Hold on. And if you say something that I don't agree with, I'm gonna have something to say, right? So that's a debate. Now, a debate is not always a bad thing, because at the end of the debate, if we can come to some common understanding, then a goal was achieved, right? Give me debate that goal. So this is actually what we're supposed to do. The Bible actually tells us to come out here and talk to the people, because I need to know what you think. You need to know what I think. And if you can teach me something, guess what I'm going to say? All praises. I learned something today, and vice versa. So we're not out here saying, oh, we the only ones with the answers. You're an older man. How old are you, bro, if you don't mind me asking? You're 52. I'm only 38 years old. There's some things you've experienced in life that I've never experienced. You can help me there. You see what I'm saying? I've been studying this Bible for 3 years now. I might know some things in here that you don't. I might be able to help you there. That's all we out here saying. So when we come out here, we out here to show y'all things that you probably don't know in the Bible.
That's right.
So I'm going to ask you this. Before we just read out the Bible, that God had a favorite people on the face of the earth, did you know that?
Yeah.
You know
that.
So you knew?
Oh,
praise. That's a great question. Go ahead. Hold that thought, brother. Go ahead. Yes, sir. Go ahead. That's right. Now go ahead, bro. I understand what you're saying. Everybody don't eat what I eat. That's right.
You can't feed everybody or put this type of ingredients in.
I agree with you. What you just said is, if I'm a cook and I work in the kitchen and I'm cooking, everybody don't eat. Absolutely right. But my job as a cook is to do what? All I'm here to do is prepare the food. Now, you're going to eat it, whether you eat it or not. That's on you.
You work it, and you got to make sure that the people eat them.
Look, the restaurant that I cook for is the Most High's restaurant. The Most High's telling me to prepare one type of dish. Now, you as a customer, when you come to the Most High's restaurant, you either going to eat what we cooking or you not. Right or wrong? Hold on, brother. I got it. He's next. Read that.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 11.
and go get thee to them of the captivity.
So the Most High said, come out here to the people of the captivity. That's all of us. It ain't like we free and y'all not. None of us free. We all in the captivity. Go ahead.
Unto the children of thy people, and speak unto them, and tell them, thus saith the Lord God, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear.
That's what he just said. The Most High God telling me to come out here, what to say out the Bible. I ain't telling you my words. All I'm doing is reading what the Bible say, right? Either you accept it or you don't. And that's, I don't have a problem with that. I'm just doing what the Most High told me to do. Now, brother, you said, what does that have to do with today's day and time, right? It's a great question. So let me ask you this. In today's day and time, these people on this time, which are the Israelites, are they on the bottom of society?
Hey, that's
but that's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about these people. No, listen to what I'm saying. Do we look like, I'm not going to war with you. We sitting here having a conversation. But how was that a war if we sitting here having a conversation? Let me have a conversation if we don't go back and forth. If I'm just doing all the talking and you doing all the listening, that ain't a conversation, right? So in order for us to have a conversation, we gotta go back and forth, right?
Right.
It's okay. See, we've been so trained that if I raise my voice and you raise your voice, people think we arguing. No, we just both passionate about what we talking about. That's how men talk.
That's right.
That don't mean I hate you. We can yell and go back and forth with each other. And at the end of the day, I'm going to dap you up and say, I love you, bro. I'll see you next week. That's love. That's what I'm supposed to do with you. So this is what I'm about to say, because you said, what does that have to do with today? Now, this. So let me ask you this. What God do you believe in? Because I'm dealing with you. I ain't worried about everybody else right now. I'm dealing with you. So what do you believe in? Okay, of course you believe in living because you got to get up every day. But who gave you life? Who gave them life? And so on and so forth, right? Who gave that first person life? Now hold up, bro. Now listen to what you just said. But listen, how is it not going to be a first person? If you come down through the line, somebody, it had to start somewhere, right? It goes back to the beginning. So you don't believe in Adam and Eve? So let me ask you this. You believe in slavery? Do you know for a fact that slavery happened? You don't know. You see racism. Okay, let me show you this in the Bible. Go to Deuteronomy 28. So let me ask you this. When you go to get something to eat, who do you go get something to eat from? Who owns the stores that we go get our food from? The Asians. Go ahead. Who else? Koreans. The Arabs. Go ahead. What black people do you know got a store? Okay. Now, there's a few out here right now. When they go get the products to put in that store that they own, where do they get those products from? One of them other nations, right? So what now, when you pay your water, you got in your house, you got water, right? Who do you pay your water bill to?
White man.
You pay your water bill to a black man? No. You don't pay your water bill to him. The water bill goes to the utility company. You may pay rent to him. It goes to the city. Okay. Who do you pay taxes to? So this is what I'm showing y'all. When you go to buy clothes, who owns the store that you go get the clothes from? The other nation. Exactly. So exactly what this brother said. So what I'm going to show you is the Bible. The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore, shalt thou serve thy enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things. And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee. So the Bible just said that everything you want in life, regardless of who you think you're getting it from, it says at the end of the day, it comes from your enemy, whether it's water, food, clothing, shelter. And it said these same group of people put shackles of iron around your neck. So, brother, who put shackles of iron around our neck?
I need to hear that one.
phone. Listen. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore, shalt thou serve thy enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee.
So we're going to go slow. It said, therefore shall we serve our enemies, it said, which the Lord has sent against them. So it's going to identify our enemies, but what we need to realize is the Most High God sent this group of people against us, right? You with me, brother? All right, go ahead.
In hunger.
So it said we're going to serve them in hunger. So we went through it. Wherever you go get your food from, whether it's the McDonald's, the Hardee's, the market, pizza place, it's one of these other nations that owns it, okay? So that's the hunger we talked about.
And in thirst.
In thirst. Whether it's water that's coming out of your faucet, whether you're going across the street to get a water, whether you're going over here to get a bin, whatever you're going to, that's thirst-wise, liquid-wise, you got to get it from one of these other nations, all right?
And in nakedness.
So even when it comes down to your clothing, you got to go to another nation of people to get clothes for you and your family. The Bible is telling us this. Watch this.
And in want of all things.
It says, in want of all things. So, brother, if you want a driver's license, who you got to go to?
Okay,
brother don't want to interact with me. If you got to get a driver's license, brother, who you got to go to get a driver's license from?
You got to go to the white people.
If you get a birth certificate, to the government, which is who? That's the white people. You ain't got to be afraid to say it. You ain't got to be afraid to say it. So look. Hold on. Because you wanted me to finish this verse. So even if you die, because it said in one of all things, before your people can even get the insurance money, they got to produce what? A death certificate. Who you got to go to get a death certificate from? Through the white people. Okay, so the Bible just made it clear. Whatever you want, you're going to have to go to your enemies for. And it's going to tell us one last thing about our enemies.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he hath destroyed thee.
So it said he's going to put a yoke of iron around our neck until he has destroyed us. Now, you can't say that everybody in history went through that. Everybody didn't go through this right here. All these Chinese people don't have to go to somebody else to get water, food, and something to drink. They got their own stores. Exactly. They never had shackles around their necks like this. The Bible is telling you that this people that it's talking about is us. Now, what's your question, brother?
My question is this, right? Going back to the Bible, right? Going back to the Bible, right? And going all the way really to Genesis, man. God cast out Satan and his followers.
Huh?
And jumping all the way up to saying, but you're saying specifically the New Testament, where it says in Matthew about the 12 tribes of Israel.
Right.
Yeah. 12,000 out of the 12,000 tribes. I mean, 12,000.
12,000 from each tribe.
Right. Out of the 12 tribes of Israel.
Right.
It's going to be serving with God.
I said,
out of the 12 tribes of Israel, right, in the Bible, it says that 12,000 will be picked out of these 12 tribes.
Right.
That's 144,000.
Absolutely.
Where do we fall in it?
Even though
we might be descendants of that, but the 12,000, which makes the 144,000 that he's talking about, is like replacement for the angels that he cast out when back in Genesis when he cast Satan and his followers out.
Okay, that's a great question.
A lot of people had this question. Most of that comes from Jehovah's Witness. Okay? And no, just listen to me. Brother, listen to me. What I'm getting ready to tell you is the thought that it's only 144,000 that's going to be saved, that's a Jehovah's Witness doctrine. Listen, I'll let you talk, right?
Okay, yes, sir.
You ask the question, I'm going to answer it. Let's read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 7, verse 4. And I heard the number of them which was sealed, and there was sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of children of Israel.
So that's what you just said. That's the 144,000, right? So we're on the same page. Go ahead.
Of the tribe of Judah was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Reuben was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Gad was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Asher was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Naphtali was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Manasseh was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Simeon was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Levi was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Issachar was still 12,000. Of the tribe of Zebulun was still 12,000. And the tribe of Joseph was still 12,000. And the tribe of Benjamin was still 12,000. After this, I beheld.
Now, hold on. So that was the 12,000 from each tribe that you talked about, right? Now the Bible says what?
After this, I beheld.
It says after that, after the 144,000, now he saw something else.
And lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and peoples and tongues, stood before the throne, before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands.
So, he said he saw the 144,000 that you were just talking about. Those are going to be the leaders. Those are the elect, because they got to be set up to run the world. Because when Christ come back, heaven is not in the sky floating around. When Christ come back, heaven is going to be right here on earth. Those 144,000 men, those are the leaders of the world. So they're going to be running the government. It says now, they got to have, in a government, you got to have some people to govern, right? That's this multitude. So when you say, where do we fit in? We fit in this multitude. Read it again.
The book of Revelation chapter 7, verse 9. After this I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number, of all nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hands.
So that's the rest of us. So go ahead.
Okay, what I'm saying is the way that you're presenting it is almost like it's just the 12 tribes of Israel. Everybody who's going to be saved and this, that, and the other is only coming from the 12 tribes.
I got you. So what you heard was...
Because you see, in Psalm 33:8, I believe it is, or 83:8, it tells you that the meek shall inherit the earth. So I already know it's going to be a great people on the earth. You already know that, as Christ said, he's going to raise the dead first.
Right.
So you know it's already going to be people here.
Okay, so what you're saying is, so you don't think it's only Israelites that's going to be saved, is what you're saying?
What I'm saying is that out of the 12 tribes of Israel,
right,
y'all just saying that the way that you presented it is like only these people be around.
No. If that's what you're understanding, let me make it clear. The 12,000 from each tribe is the 144,000. These are going to be the leaders on the earth at this time, okay? Men, right. So after that, the rest of the people, listen. The rest of the people that's going to be in the kingdom are all Israelites. Now, is it going to be some other nations there? Yes. But guess what the other nation's going to be? Slaves. So your Chinese man that the brother was worried about, the Arab man that the brother was worried about, they're going to be our slaves in the kingdom. Now, if you don't believe me, let's see what the Bible says. Give me that in Isaiah 14.
Bring it up.
You said I put it down.
You put the Bible down. You keep putting the Bible down.
Hold on. Why do you say I'm putting the Bible down, bro? Barry. Deal with me, brother. Why am I putting the Bible down? This Bible don't never leave our mouth. This is the only thing we stand on.
That's right.
Don't be fooled over there, y'all. The brother come over there telling y'all, come over here, hear for yourself. The book of Isaiah, chapter 14, verse 2. So I'm going to repeat it again, just in case anybody missed it. When Christ returns, the 12 tribes of Israel are going to be the only ones reigning with him in the kingdom here on earth. All the other nations that you are worried about are going to be your slaves and servants. If you don't like that, I don't know what to tell you, but let's listen to what the Bible says.
The Bible of Isaiah chapter 14, verse 1. For the Lord would have mercy on Jacob.
The Lord is going to have mercy on Jacob.
And will yet choose Israel.
And he's still going to choose Israel. Regardless of what it looks like now, he's still only choosing these people on this side. Go ahead.
And set them in their own land.
He's going to set us in our own land. Because right now we're in the white man's land. Read.
And the strangers shall be joined with them.
It says, and the strangers are going to be joined with them. That's all the other nations that y'all can't get out of y'all head. That's your Chinese, your Japanese, your East Indian, your Arab, your African. These are all the other nations. They are called strangers right now. What does the Bible say about these strangers?
And they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
They're going to cleave to us because they're going to realize who they've been dealing with the whole time. They're going to realize that they had God's precious children in slavery the whole time. And then what?
And the people shall take them and bring them to that place.
It said, we're going to take them. We're going to take them. That means aggressively. We're not going to ask them to come with us. We're taking them.
Right.
This is what the Bible says. And then what?
And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids.
The Bible just said we're going to possess all the people for servants and handmaids.
That's right.
We just read that out. The Holy King James Bible that all y'all got at home.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.